All right, this morning we are talking about two things, jealousy and envy. Now, at the first look, we may think jealousy and envy are the same thing, are the same word. They're a little different, and we see both sides of it in our scripture today. Okay, jealousy. How would you describe jealousy? Yep. You hit the thing right on there. It's something you're jealous about, something you don't want to lose, particularly a relationship. Well, that's true. That's true. You're not jealous of that. No. I don't want to lose a relationship. Now, we see it in our story today. The other brothers are very, very jealous of Joseph because they're afraid they're losing their relationship with their dad. Because Jacob loves him clearly more than them. Now, envy is a little different. Envy is, I want what he has. So I'm jealous of losing my relationship with my father, but I also want what he has. He has that special relationship. He has now this pretty schnazzy coat. And he has these visions. It seems like he has everything. So they are not only jealous. Sometimes we're jealous by itself and not envious. Sometimes we're jealous and envious at the same time. And it brought me to, what color do we think of when we think of jealousy? What do we think of?
Green.
We think of green. Because I did not know where it came from, the idea of the green-eyed monster. But it came from, who knows, where it originally started, in what famous author?
Shakespeare.
Who?
Shakespeare.
It was from Shakespeare. I did not know that. Now, you all have to be the green-eyed monsters, of course, because that's what all those brothers looked like. They were the green-eyed monsters. And what happened in our story when the green-eyed monster, the jealousy and the envy of, I want that relationship with my father, and I want those beautiful things and those visions that he has, what happens to them? What do they do? Yeah. They say, okay, we're on the field, and we have had enough. The green-eyed monster has gotten a hold of them. And what happens with jealousy, it starts to seep little by little in envy. So we see at the beginning of the story, I'm sure if we heard in the scriptures the days leading up to that, it would be them bickering between each other, saying, can you believe that Joseph, he thinks he knows everything, I can hardly stand him, what are we going to do about him? Day after day, they start to get a little bit more jealous, a little bit more envious, until they can't take it anymore. So they're out in the field that day, and they're starting to see what he looks like and what he's doing, and now he comes on top of it out to the field to tell him how to take care of the sheep, and is wearing this amazing coat. So they start to get this idea, we just cannot take it anymore. We are going to throw him down into the pit, and for just a moment, Reuben backs him up a little bit and says, no, we can't kill him. That would just be going too far. Oh, wait, as Lee said, that's all right, we'll do the much better, the most more humane, and we will sell him away, and he will be gone. So what happens with jealousy? It seeps into us and takes over any good thoughts that we have, any good loving thoughts that we have. Does jealousy and happiness go together?
No.
Jealousy and happiness is the opposite of each other. It's not over the jealousy. Peace. Does peace go with jealousy and envy? Peace does not go with jealousy. It's unsettling. It's uncontrollable, jealousy and envy. Not peaceful at all. And as Sally referred to, we have seen jealousy and envy this week in the news, in what has happened. How jealousy of afraid of losing something and envious of what you want to have in your life takes over. So I want you to think, we all are going to have moments when we're jealous and envious. Always. There's always going to be a day when the green-eyed monster comes out. But the idea is to remember to back up and say, The love of God does not know jealousy or envy. The love of God knows happiness and peace. And we can get a clean slate each day. But if we let that take over our lives each and every day, there may be no coming back from that. No peace and happiness. Let us pray. Dear God, sometimes the green-eyed monster takes over. Help us to recognize that your love is stronger. You will always love us. Our relationship with you will always be there and strong and true. Amen.